ब्रह्मा दिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो ऋषिभ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरितः प्रज्ञानं प्रत्यगर्तो ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि नारायणं पद्मद्वयं वसिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्र पराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौडपदं महान्तं गोविंद योगींद्र मथासि शिष्यं श्रीशंकराचार्य मथासि पद्मपादं च हस्तामलकं च शिष्यं तंतोटकं वार्तिककारमन्यानस्मद्गुरून् सन्ततमानतोऽस्मि श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावतीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः यद्ब्रह्मगोचरविचित्रतमः प्रभावात् संसारधीजनितदुःखमभूज्जनस्य यद्ब्रह्मधीजनितसौख्यमभूच्च तस्य तं रुक्मिणीसहितकृष्णमहं नमामि यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरी सहोदरापमहत्पदम् तमहं आशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकजाङ्कमनन्तसुखाकृतिम् सो या या आई एम जस्ट आई सर्च दिस पेज एंड देन स्प्लिट इट थैंक्स सो ये व्हाइट स्क्रीन अगेन I'm seeing white screen. Let me reopen the app. To move this, what happens? No. I'll open the app again. Share again. Has the screen come up?
Yes, I'm properly.
Yeah. Double thanks. Okay. 10 minutes late after 15 minutes. Okay. So let's see how much we can do. So, Nacha. तदनन्यत्वाधिकरणे तस्य वर्णनात् पौनरुक्त्यम् रत्नप्रभाकर दिस इज नच ही एक्सपेक्ट्स अ पूर्वपक्ष एज टू अध्यास अ डिस्कशन इज गोइंग टू टेक प्लेस गिवन इन दी तदनन्यत्व अधिकरण द सेकंड चैप्टर फर्स्ट पाद 15 सूत्र सो देर तस्य अध्यासस्य वर्णनात् देर इज अ डिस्कशन देर आल्सो सो न पुनः नच वाच्यम यू शुड नॉट से पौनरुक्त्यम There's a repetition. Ponaruktam is a dosha. You should not raise this dosha. Why so? Here, first of all, adhyasa is introduced here. It is explained. And then, it is going to be discussed in detail there as well. But here, it is briefly introduced and the objections of a different kind are taken here. And there is a vistarana there. So, an introduction and an elaboration elsewhere does not mean punarukti. Only if the same thing is repeated again and again, it is a punarukti dosha. Here, there is no such dosha. That is the idea there. Tatra ukta adhyasasya eva. The adhyasa which is being talked about here, tasya eva pravrittyanga vishayadi siddhyartham ado smaryamanatvad iti dhik. Says, don't bring this kind of objection because the same adhyasa is going to be discussed there with a pravrutyanga vishayadi siddhyartham. that adhyasa which is going to come up there itself has been introduced here with the vishaya siddhi. The vishaya is jnana, aikya of the through jnana, the aikya jnana, aikya between Brahma and Atma, that is the vishaya. And for this vishaya siddhi by jnanena eva kaivalyam, jnanadeva kaivalyam, for that siddhi this adhyasa has to be accepted, and that is the context here, not what is the context in the sutra. There the adhyasa proper may be discussed, but it is not a punarukti dosha iti dik. So smaryamana, so it is just it is making you recall that sutra, but then that is not the focus here. So we are going beyond the scope of this discussion. Don't bring this up. This is what the Ratna Prabhakara says. Tika. Tachya. Okay. I should have marked in the Tika. Bhashya is easy to find. I should have marked it in the Ponarukti Nana Sambhavati Vishayati. Saiva Artharuba Adhyasa Vishayasya Jnana. Not this Sambhavati. Ponarukti. Yeah. So here we saw that Punarukti Dosha in not Loka Vyavahara. Punarha. Digiti. Yeah. So Digiti. The discretion there is. We saw Purva Dwara. Nacha Ityadi Granthastu. Atirohitartha. Not tirohitartha. It is not being, tiroha is, what do you say, it's a negation, some kind of a negation here. It is not that kind of a discussion here. Nanu, vishyadi siddhyartham adau eva adhyasasya avashyakatvena arthikartataya yuktyacha varnitatvat punastad ananyatvadhikarne tadvarnanam punaruktam eva adhikarnasya gatartatvad ityataha. So adhikarna, the adhyasa discussion in that adhikarana is already done here. This adhikarana is over. Adhyasa kind of adhikarana is over. If that is the objection, it is not so. So therefore, this nacha ityadi grantha to atirohitartha. There is no tirohana done there. So here it is meaning a smaryamanatva. So it is not, we were not lost sight of that. In fact, keeping that in the mind, so that atirohitartha means that we have not lost sight of that, that adhikarana is there, and you cannot say when you reach that adhikarana that is gatartha, meaning already dealt with, why are you bringing it away? It is not a punarukti dosha, that is the idea there. So I am Ashaya, what is the idea there? Adhika shanka nirasarthatvena pravruttasya tad adhikaranasya na gatarthata. The ideas discussed there are because the questions are different, there are more doubts. The more you learn, the more doubts come up. It is not that you cannot revisit a similar topic with different set of doubts. Therefore, that section deals with a different kind of doubts. Here we are trying to establish the Vishaya, Vishayadi, Anubandha Chatushtaya, and how that Vishaya Siddhi is being done is by accepting adhyasa and thereby jnanena mokshaha. Yataha sangrahasya vivaranam ataha. So yataha sangrahasya vivaranam, this is the sangraha, there it is, vivarana, there is an elaborate discussion on same adhyasa but with a different set of doubts. So that's the idea. Ataha na punaruktata iti alam atik prasangena. So beyond the context, you have brought up some doubt, but anyway, we have dealt with it. There is nothing more that needs to be discussed in that case. Now, moving on to the next part of the Adhyasa Bhashya, where Loka Vyavahara, Ayam Loka Vyavahara was discussed, and Ayam was mentioned there. Ayam meaning Adhyasasya Abhanam cannot be mentioned by the Purva Pakshi, meaning adhyasa, whether it is illogical or whether there is abhana, that was an option given, second option. First option was, it is illogical, does not seem right. We agree it does not seem right. And then abhana, in the context of abhana, this was discussed as to, you cannot say that there is no bhana of adhyasa. This very manushyayam is the bhana of adhyasa. There the Purvapakshi had said, no, this need not be adhyasa, this bhana can be real. Aham manushya, aham karta, aham ajnaha, this can be real also. And there we discussed the Shruti Vakya, saying Shruti Virodha, and Satyattvam also we discussed as to what is this Satyattvam, making the four divisions. Now, that ayam loka vyavaharaha, this word, set of two words in a samasa are discussed as loka vyavaharaha. So here the Tikakara says, loka sahito vyavahara loka vyavaharaha. There are two things here, loka and vyavahara. Although why dvandva has not been done, Bhagavan Bhashyakara is indicating two things there. What is he indicating? By loka he is indicating something, and by vyavahara he is indicating something. So there is a Purvapaksha to this, as to ayam, this ayam is showing adhyasa is pratyaksha, and loka vyavahara also shows adhyasa. What is that adhyasa? Loka is also adhyasa, vyavahara is also adhyasa. Different kind. Loka is arthadhyasa, vishaya, and vyavahara is jnanadhyasa. In the case of Rajju Sarpa, instead of the Rajju Sarpa is being seen, that Sarpa is outside, is seen outside. So the vishaya Sarpa is there, artha. So that artha, adhyasa is there. It is not there, therefore it is an adhyasa. Meaning Sarpa is not there, therefore it is an adhyasa. For this vishaya, there is a jnana. Meaning jnana and vishaya go together here, as to there is a jnana also. Sarpa jnana takes place. There is a snake. And that snake, where is it? It is outside there. So that vishaya outside, seen outside, there is a anirvachaniya utpatti of Sarpa. And there is an anirvachaniya utpatti of jnana in the buddhi as to sarpa. So sarpa vishayaka jnana is there. Jnana is sarpa jnana, and it is sarpa vishayaka jnana. So sarpa vishaya is also there, sarpa jnana is also there. Sarpa vishaya is called as arthadhyasa in that case. Wherever there is an adhyasa, there vishaya is also adhyasta, jnana is also adhyasta. Therefore vishaya is indicated by the word loka here, meaning vishaya adhyasa, artha adhyasa is indicated by the word loka here in the adhyasa vashya, whereas vyavahara shows the jnana adhyasa. If, see, vishaya, artha adhyasa, vishaya and jnana are not same, artha adhyasa is different, jnana adhyasa is different, then why not make it a dvandva? You have to make it an itaretara dvandva. This is the Purvapaksha there. So loka vyavahara is an ekavachana in pullinga, that too. So it cannot be samahara dvandva. It is not samahara dvandva, then it is itaretara dvandva. If it is itaretara dvandva, then it should be dual. It should have been dvivachana loka vyavaharau. This is the thinking of the Purvapakshi. So he says, your interpretation of saying that loka and vyavahara are two adhyasas indicated by Bhagavan Bhashyakara is not right. Otherwise he would have made it a dvandva. Then the Tikakara is responding, Siddhanti responds, saying loka sahito vyavahara loka vyavahara. Madhyam pada lopa samasa is there. Although there are two things, you need not make it a dvandva if there is a connection between the two, and you want to show the connection also. Like the samasa shaka parthiva samasa in Vyakarana. Shaka means vegetable, parthiva means a king. So what does it mean by saying vegetable king? It means the king who likes vegetable, to whom vegetables are dear. So shaka parthiva is a madhyama pada lopi samasa, where the middle word has been dropped. What is that middle word? That is priya. So shaka priya parthiva, shaka parthiva. Similarly here, loka sahita vyavahara, loka vyavahara, sahita is a madhyama pada which has undergone lopa. Iti madhyama pada lopa samasa ekavachane api द्वैविष्यं युक्तमेव इति अभिप्रेत्य भाष्यम अवतारयति अध्यासम इति. सो कंसीडरिंग दैट काइंड ऑफ मध्यम पद लोपी समास लोक एंड व्यवहार आर टू विषयास टू द्वैविष्यं सॉरी द्वैविध्यं. सो एकवचनेन अपि द्वैविध्यं युक्तमेव. सो these two padas can be talking of two different things even if it is declined, the compound samasa is declined in a singular, therefore dvaividyam yuktam eva iti abhipretya bhashyam avatarayati brings down the bhashya to comment upon who the ratna prabhakara adhyasam iti. So here adhyasam dvedha darshayati bhagwan bhashyakara adhyasam dvedha darshayati shows adhyasa is of two types. There's a different way of dividing. So there are multiple ways to look at adhyasa. We'll look at what all words have come up in relation to adhyasa. After we go through all sorts of discussions on adhyasa, then we'll summarize as to which are these words which talk about adhyasa. So dvedha darshayati, with one prakara, there is a twofold division of अध्यास एंड दैट इज शोन बाय भगवान भाष्यकर वाइसिंग लोक व्यवहार इति अयम लोक व्यवहार नैसर्गिको अयम लोक व्यवहार इति. सो लोक व्यवहार इति लोक्यते मनुष्यः अहम् इति अभिमन्यते इति लोकः अर्थाध्यास. लोक्यते लोक्यते इति लोकः कर्मणि व्युत्पत्ति. सो लोक्यते मनुष्यः अहम् इति मीनिंग अभिमन्यते. People consider themselves as manushya. Iti lokaha. Therefore, this adhyasa, which is vishayadhyasa, consider themselves as the sharira. Manushya is deha. Deha has manushyatvam, and one considers oneself as deha. Oneself as deha. Therefore, there is arthadhyasa. The deha is superimposed upon atma oneself. That is the arthadhyasa. टीका लोक्यते यः स लोक इति कर्मणि व्युत्पत्त्या कर्म व्युत्पत्ति. सो कर्म व्युत्पत्ति इज कर्मणि व्युत्पत्त्या. देयर इज अ समस्त पदा देयर. सो कर्म व्युत्पत्त्या अर्थाध्यास परत्वेन लोकपदं व्याचष्टे. अर्थाध्यास परत्वेन मीन्स तात्पर्य इज अर्थाध्यास. अर्थाध्यास तात्पर्येण लोकपदं व्याचष्टे. Lokapada is being described as what is committed to, is what reveals the arthadhyasa by karmani vipatti. Lokyate iti lokaha. And what is loka? Their lokyate iti, their lokyate is abhimanyate, have abhimana in the sharira. Meaning there is a tadatme sambandha in the sharira. And sharira is taken as oneself, therefore vishaya is taken as oneself, there is an arthadhyasa. Of course, there is a jnana also along with it, but it is secondary. So that also will be mentioned further. So manushya padam purvam vyakhyatam. Manushya padam has been mentioned earlier as relating to deha. It is a deha dharma. Manushyoham iti dehaankara adi artharupa. Dehaankara adi artharupaha visheyarupaha jnana upasarjana arthadhyasaha. So jnana upasarjana. Upasarjana means secondary. Jnana is there. When you say that I am a manushya, then manushyatva jnana is there. But manushyatvam is in the deha, and that deha is considered as oneself. Therefore, the vishaya, deha vishaya, artha is superimposed on oneself. That is the primary focus there in mentioning lokyate. Abhimana is there. Although jnana is there, but jnana is secondary. What comes to mind is the deha vishaya itself. So the deha ahankara adi, deha ahankare, sukshma sharira, all the koshas that we talk about, they are considered as atma. They are not known as koshas. Therefore, artharupa, they are all artharupa, and they vishaya, which are taken to be oneself. Jnana is definitely there in that understanding also, but that jnana, in that superimposition, adhyasa, jnana is also there. But jnana is secondary, vishaya is primary. So jnana upasarjanaha, arthadhyasa. What is arthadhyasa? Jnanam upasarjanam yasya arthadhyasasya sa arthadhyasa jnana upasarjanaha. in which jnana is secondary. Nanu lokapadasya karmavyutpattyangikarena tatsahacharyad vyavahara padasyapi karmavyutpatti syad iti ashankya ubhayo karmaparatve paunaruktyat na sambhavati ityah tadvishaye iti. So Purvapakshi says that loka is karmani vitpatti, it is an adhyasa, it is arthadhyasa. Now what about vyavahara? Vyavahara also is an adhyasa, you said, but it is along with loka, compounded along with loka. Therefore, loka being karmani vitpatti, vyavahara also has to be karmani vitpatti. This is the thinking. Why? Sahacharyat, they go together. Loka and vyavahara have gone together in a compound. Both are adhyasas. Loka is arthadhyasa by karmani vitpatti. Then that which is objectified are karmani vitpatti is an object, object of the dhatu. So here vishaya, it's an object, vishaya, deha, and that is taken to be oneself. So vyavahara also, because of going together with loka, should be by karmani vitpatti. This is an expectancy. Iti ashankya ubhayo karma paratve, if both are karmani vyutpatti, then what will happen? Paunarukti dosha. Paunaruktyat na sambhavati ityaha. Because we want to show two things. It is not in karmadhara or saying explanation of one word. In bhashya, you can have commentary on bhashya words also. It is not a commentary on the loka. Vyavahara is not an explanation of loka. It is a different adhyasa. Therefore, tadvishaya iti. So, tadvishayaha in Ratna Prabha, tadvishayo vyavaharo abhimana iti jnanadhyasa darshitaha. By vyavahara, vyavahara iti. The vyavahara pada in loka vyavahara shows jnanadhyasa, abhimana iti. So, tadvishayaha, tadvishaya is the arthadhyasa vishayaha. Arthadhyasa adhyasta, that loka vishayaha. Lokaha vishayaha yasya vyavaharasya. So that adhyasya vishayaha vyavaharaha. So vyavahara there is abhimana. Where there is abhimana in that. Iti jnanadhyasa darshitaha. That is jnanadhyasa. Meaning, what is that adhyasa? It is a jnana which is adhyasya. So jnanadhyasa, jnana is regarding which vishaya. So that vishaya, where there is arthadhyasa, which we talked about loka as arthadhyasa, so sarpa, take sarpa. So sarpa vishaya is arthadhyasa. And that kind of an adhyasa sarpa is the vishaya for which jnana. That jnana is what? Jnanadhyasa, called as vyavahara. So sarpa vishaya adhyasa arthadhyasa is indicated by loka, is the meaning of the word loka by karmani vyutpatti, and by bhavi vyutpatti jnanam regarding that vishaya is vyavahara, meaning jnana adhyasa. So that is the idea here. Tadvishayaha vyavaharaha, meaning abhimana, deha vishaya abhimanaha, dehaha vishaya yasya abhimanasya, that abhimana is what? Jnanadhyasa. It is deha vishaya yasya, so that will be deha vishayaka jnanam. Yasya jnanasya, and that jnana is adhyasa, because vishaya is also adhyasa. Therefore, by bhavi vipatti, you will get jnanadhyasa. By vyavahara shabda, jnanadhyasa darshitaha. Tika, sa eva artha rupa adhyasa vishayasya. So saha eva, in this case of shukti rajata, rajata is adhyasa, vishaya is also adhyasa, and jnana regarding the rajata is also adhyasa, but that is jnanadhyasa. So rajatam vishaya yasya jnanasya tajnanam rajata vishayaka jnanam. So tad vishayaka jnanam, and thereby it is also adhyasa, it is jnanadhyasa. In the case of deha, deha is the vishaya for which vyavahara. What is that vyavahara? It is an abhimana, abhimana rupa vyavahara. For that, vyavahara, deha is vishaya. And then one ends up with a tadatmya sambandha. Therefore, not being deha, considering oneself deha, there jnana is primary. And deha vishaya is secondary. There, again, in the jnana also without vishaya, you cannot have this. Jnana is a sakarmaka dhatu. It takes a karma. Which is the karma? The vishaya adhyasa. Artharupa adhyasa. That artharupa adhyasa is the vishaya, is the karma to this jnana. So, artharupa adhyasa karmaka jnanam. That jnana, vyavahara, which is jnana. That will also be adhyasa because the vishaya is adhyasa. And what is this jnana? Not only asti, aham asmi. Not deha asti, deha aham asmi. Thereby, there is an adhyasa and then that jnana, vishaya is there but the vishaya is upasarjana. Just like in the earlier arthadhyasa, jnana is also there but jnana is upasarjana, is secondary. In this jnanadhyasa, jnana is primary, vishaya is secondary. Therefore, loka is arthadhyasa, primarily dealing with artha vishaya and jnana being secondary and vyavahara by bhavi vipatti means jnana and it is also nadhyasa. There also vishaya is there but that artha rupa adhyasa is vishaya as secondary but jnana is primary. This is the difference between the artha adhyasa and jnana adhyasa. So saiva artha rupa adhyasa vishaya asya jnana rupa adhyasasya saha jnana rupa adhyasa tatha. That is a compound there, meaning it is actually ending with the word vyavahara. Meaning is given here, but the bhavi vyutpatti means jnana by the term, indicated by the term vyavahara in the bhashya. Ratna Prabha, divida adhyasasya swarupa lakshanamaha. What is the swarupa of this twofold adhyasa, loka vyavahara? That has been mentioned as anyonyasmin, anyonyatmakatam. So, if you look at the bhashya there, it said, tathapi anyonyasmin anyonyatmakatam. Scrolling across pages. So, anyonyatmakatam, anyonya dharmanscha adhyasya itaretara avivekena atyanta viviktayor dharma dharminoho. Across multiple pages, okay. Dharma dharmino ho. That is why I had opened Advaita Sharada. Dharma dharmino. I missed one page. Yeah, so dharma dharminoho mithya jnana nimitta satyanrute mithuni krutya aham idam mama idam iti naisargikoyam lokavyavaharaha. So again, tatahi, what has been said is, after the first sentence, we have seen this sentence in the bhashya as tathapi anyonyasmin anyonyatmakatam anyonya dharmanscha adhyasya, having done adhyasa of the, between the dharmis and dharmas, there is an adhyasa. And what is this adhyasa now? Ayam loka vyavahara, there is an arthadhyasa also, and there is a jnanadhyasa also, and adhyasya itaretara avivekena. Once there is an adhyasa, then one cannot discriminate the two, atma and anatma, jada and chetana, thereby atyanta viviktayor dharma dharminoho. Dharmas are many. Then these dharmas are in the dharmi. These dharmis are two. Atma and anatma are two dharmis. And although their dharmas are multiple. So dharma dharminoho means dharmanam dharminoho. Between the dharmas there is an adhyasa. Between the dharmas, in the sense, dharmas resting in which dharmi, there is a confusion. And dharmis themselves are are mixed up. Itare itara avivekena. One is unable to separate the dharmas also as not belonging to particular dharmi, and one is unable to separate the dharmis themselves. That is the reason. In fact, the latter, dharmi indiscrimination, is the reason for the dharmadhyasa. This was mentioned earlier. Now, atyanta viviktayor, they are completely opposed to each other. Tam prakashavat, both these dharmis are completely opposed to each other, but atyanta viviktayor dharma dharmino ho mithyajnana nimitta. So what was said as mithyajnana nimitta? There is adhyasa, but what is that? That is mithyajnana nimitta. And mithyajnana nimitta satyanrute mithunikritya. Having mixed up this satya, chetana atma, and anruta, jada anatma, mithunikritya, having mixed them up as one, aham idam mama idam iti naisargikoyam lokavyavaharaha. So aham, ahankara, in the deha, and then anything associated with the deha we considered as our mama. This is a loka vyavahara. Now loka is arthadhyasa and vyavahara is jnanadhyasa. That is discussed. Further what is said is in the Ratna Prabha, satyam anidam chaitanyam antyena ityantyena. Went one page ahead. So dvividha adhyasa swarupa lakshanamaha. What is this swarupa lakshana of this twofold adhyasa in the bhashya anyonyasmin ityadina dharma dharminor ityantena, beginning with anyonyasmin, ending with dharma dharminor, the initial two words there of that sentence in the adhyasa bhashya. Tika, ननु व्यवहार शब्दस्य अभिज्ञा अभिवदनम अर्थक्रिया च इति बहुहर्त संभवात् किमत्र विवक्षितम् इत्याशंक्य अभिज्ञार्थकत्वम् इत्याह अभिमान इति इति इति. सो दिस व्यवहार शब्द हैज मल्टीपल मीनिंग्स, मेनी मीनिंग्स आर देयर इन दिस व्यवहार. व्हाट आर द मीनिंग्स जनरली नो व्यवहार शब्दस्य इन द लोक व्यवहार शब्द व्यवहार शब्दस्य अभिज्ञा अभिवदनम अर्थक्रिया. Three are taken. There is a fourth meaning also. Chaiti. Bauharata sambhavat. So, not only three, there are other meanings possible. What is the meaning among those three, four meanings of the word vyavahara? Kimatra vyokshitam. What is intended? Iti ashankya abhijnyarthakattvam ityah. So, vyavahara is talked about in the Panchapadika. In Panchapadika, vyavahara is discussed not as a dictionary meaning. Vyavahara, dictionary meaning will be there, but how it is used in the context, what all meanings can be even considered, whether they apply here, there. Panchapadikara says abhijna is one meaning of vyavahara. Abhijna means jnanam. Pratyabhijna. So pratyabhijna is soyam. I am the same person. So aham, soham. Soyam devadatta, there is a pratyabhijna. So I am the same person who slept yesterday and woke up this morning. That is also pratyabhijna. It is jnana. So abhijna. Abhijna is not pratyabhijna. Abhijna is just jnana. Pratyabhijna is a particular kind of jnana where you connect two units of knowledge. And there is a continuity, anvaya of something between these two units of knowledge. So it's a prati abhijna, pratyabhijna. Abhijna is jnana, this is abhijna is the meaning. Jnana is one meaning of vyavahara, which is what you have taken. Abhivadana is also the meaning. Abhivadana is shabda prayoga, kathanam, just a narration, vyavahara. So you use a word and you say adhyasa vyavahara, or you say sarpa or rajju. Some word is being used there. The vyavahara of that word is just usage of that word. Kathanam. Upadhanam is one word which is not mentioned in the, one meaning which is not mentioned in the tika, but it is there in the Panchapadika. So there upadhanam is grahanam. So vyavahara is you hold on to something, you grasp something. That is also vyavahara. Arthakriya is mentioned here. Arthakriya. There arthakriya also is mentioned here as a third meaning. So artha kriya is also one meaning of vyavahara, meaning prayojana siddhi. Prayojana siddhi is one meaning of vyavahara shabda. What is intended here? Here only abhijna is intended. Actually, kathana is also there, abhivadana is also there. Abhivadana, but here Tikakara says iti ashankya abhijna arthakatvam iti ah. Only abhijna jnana is meant by vyavahara, not any shabda prayoga ityadi, not grahana, not prayojana siddhi, etc. So here vyavahara means jnana, abhimana iti iti. Therefore, abhimana is by that arthadhyasa preceding, meaning arthadhyasa being an object to this jnana, not preceding, being a vishaya to this jnana. That is abhimana iti. Arthopasarjana jnana rupa adhyasa jnanadhyasa ityartha. So jnana rupa adhyasa is what? Of course, artha is also there. Just like in arthadhyasa jnana was there, but it was secondary. Similarly, here in jnanadhyasa, artha vishaya is definitely there, but it is secondary. Ityartha. Idam rajatam ityatra jnana pradhanya vivakshaya jnanadhyasa artha pradhanya vivakshaya arthadhyasa che veditavyaha. So how should you understand this? It's an example case of shukchi rajata. Instead of shell, there is a cognition of silver. There, idam rajatam, when you say this is silver, that kind of an understanding is there, and you, let's say you state it also. Vyavahara is there. So loka, vishaya is also there. You see silver and then you, even if you don't utter it in your mind, this is silver, that knowledge takes place. So jnana pradhanya vivakshaya, with an intention of jnana being primary, what will be the adhyasa? It is jnana adhyasa. And artha pradhanya vivakshaya, when you want to give importance to the jnana itself, meaning not jnana, to the jnana vishaya itself, karma of that jnana, then that will be arthadhyasa. I mean, this is how you have active and passive voice. Karmani prayoga is by karma being important to the vivaksha. In the vivaksha, when the karma is important, then one ends up with a karmani prayoga, where the karta is gauna, bhava is gauna, kriya is gauna. Similarly, kartari prayoga is there. In that karta is pradhana, karma may or may not be there, it is secondary. Even if it is there, it is not mentioned in the vivaksha. Even if it is mentioned in the vivaksha, it is not the primary focus in the vivaksha. And in Sanskrita, you also have bhave vyutpatti, where kriya is pradhana. So here in this bhave vyutpatti of jnana, vyavahara, there what do you have? You have jnana adhyasa. So jnana itself is pradhana. Therefore, by bhave vyutpatti, jnana pradhanyena and vishaya artha upasarjanena jnana adhyasa. Whereas vishaya pradhanyena, artha pradhanyena, artha adhyasa, jnana is gauna there, jnana upasarjanena. That is the vivaksha. Evam sarvatra, and this is how it should be dealt with, as in the example case, everywhere. In the case of Dehatma Buddhi also, one should take as Arthadhyasa with Artha primary. Jnana is definitely there but secondary. And Jnanadhyasa is that where Jnana is primary and Artha is secondary in the Vivaksha. Swarupeti. So there Swarupa was mentioned there, Swarupa Lakshana. Adhyasa Swarupa Lakshana is talked about. So Tikakara says Swarupancha Tallakshanancha. Iti karmadharaya. Swarupa lakshana means what? It's a karmadharaya. Swarupa is lakshana. Swarupa lakshana. Lakshanadi bhashya siddham atmanatmanor itaretara vishayam avidyakhyam dvividha adhyasa swarupam aha ityartha. So what is this adhyasa swarupa which is mentioned? Swarupa lakshana. Definition, which is its own swarupa. So lakshanadi bhashya siddham atmanatmanor itaretara vishayam avidyakhyam. What is also called as avidya. This adhyasa is avidya karya. Sometimes avidya is used in the case of avidya karya also. Just like karma. When you say karma, karma means just kriya also, some action. It also means karma phala. Similarly, avidya itself can be used as karana or as karya also. Generally as karana, but can also mean the karya adhyasa itself. Now, lakshanadi bhashya siddham atmanatmanor itaretara vishayam. In this ajnana, adhyasa, ajnana karya, avidya karya, adhyasa, what is the vishaya? Both are vishayas. The dharmis, both dharmis are vishayas. Both dharmas are also vishayas. Therefore, atma and anatma both are vishayas and their dharmas are vishayas. Itaretara vishayam. In the case of adhyasa also, what is adhyasta on? What? Other dharmi is vishaya in the adhyasa of one dharmi and vice versa. Both are itaretara vishayam. And therefore, not being real, avidyakhyam. They are also called as avidya. Avidya iti akhyayasya. Tara avidyakhyam. That is avidyakhyam. Dvivida adhyasa swarupam aha ityartha. And thereby, two types of adhyasa of this type, which are nothing but avidya karya, also called as avidya. That lakshana is of two types. So they are of two types. Lakshanam dvividham swarupa lakshanam vyavarta lakshanam chaiti tatra bhashye kantoktihi swarupa lakshanam asti asti eva iti jnapayetum swarupa lakshanam ityuktam. So swarupa lakshana has been mentioned, but there is also vyavarta lakshana. So what is vyavarta lakshana? Swarupa lakshana is just the nature of the way the entity is. When you define the entity the way it is, then it is swarupa lakshana. Now, visheshanas are used there also. They can be misunderstood as visheshana rather. When you say satyam jnanam anantam brahma in the case of brahma, there what happens? Satyam jnanam anantam is the very swarupa of brahma, meaning brahma is satyam. It is not Brahma is that which has Satyam. There is no Sambandha there. It is not a Dharmi holding a Dharma. Satya is not a Dharma. Satyatva is not a Dharma. When you say Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, in Taittiriya Upanishad, Bhagavan Bhashyakara discusses on this mantra saying that the Vivaksha is to say Satyam Brahma, Jnanam Brahma, Anantam Brahma. Where Satyam Jnanam Anantam, elaborate discussion is there as to what Satyam means, what Jnanam means, and that is the meaning of Brahma itself. So that is Swarupa Lakshana. It is not showing some Dharma of Brahma. However, it is also Vyavartaka. Although Swarupa Lakshana is not a Visheshana, Visheshana is used as what? Itara Vyavartaka. When you say that ghata is utpala, neelotpala, raktotpala. So neelotpala means neela, neelam utpalam. But neela is the dharma of the utpala. The lily is blue means the blueness is the property of the which rests in lily. And thereby you are differentiating this lily from other lilies which are not blue. If you say, you know, this big lily, then also you are saying, no, you're differentiating from the others which are not big. That is Vyavartaka. So Visheshana is that which is Vyavartaka, Itara Vyavartaka. Here, Swarupa Lakshana and Vyavartaka Lakshanas are there. There are two types of Lakshanas also, definitions there. But then Swarupa Lakshana is mentioned here. Kantokti, Bhashyakara gives just the Swarupa Lakshana in his own words. Now, Swarupa Lakshanam asti eva iti jnapayetum. There, Swarupa Lakshanam ityuktam. Swarupa Lakshana is possible, it has been given. Swarupa Lakshane api ukte. Tannishtam asadharana dharma swarupam vyavartaka lakshanam arthat siddhyati iti bhavaha. Even when you give the Lakshana as Swarupa Lakshana, still it will differentiate from the others. For example, Sat Brahma. When you say Sat Brahma, if something which is not Sat, Sat meaning Trikala Baditam Sat, Ghatapatadi are not Trikala Abadita, they are Trikala Badita, meaning not Trikala Badita, in some Kala they are Badita. Ghatadi Prapancha, Ahankaradi Prapancha will undergo Badha in some Kala. Jnana Antaram Vastu or Nasha also. not only Badha, Nyasha is also possible, but then particularly we are interested in Badha. What cannot undergo Badha? Intention is also to say what cannot undergo Nasha. So you can consider both also, but primarily Badha. That is Mithya. It is the Badha is important because we want to differentiate Sat from Mithya. When you want to differentiate something as Sat from something which is Asat, or not Atyanta Asat, but to say that Nityattvam, you want to show Nityattvam of Brahma, then not Badha of Abrahma, but you want to show Nityattvam of Brahma, then you can show Nasha of others as well. So Ghata undergoes Nasha. Ghata is, can be, you know, you can hammer on a Ghata and then Ghata will break, or you can just drop it and it might break. So it undergoes Nasha, it is no longer a Ghata. There, when you say Brahma is Nitya, it is a Swarupa Lakshana. Nityattvam is not a dharma per se, but then it will also differentiate from Anitya Ghata. Similarly, when you say Brahma is Sad Brahma, it will differentiate from Asat also, Shasha Vishanadi, Atyanta Asat. It will also differentiate Brahma from what? From Mithya, Ghatapatadi, which are not Trikala Badita. Not Trikala Abadita, they are Trikala Abadita. Brahma is Trikala Abadita, meaning never negated in any three period, any of the three periods of time, whereas Trikala Abadita, Ghatapatadi, Ahankaradi, Prapancha are not. So there is Itara Vyavartakatvam also. As soon as Swarupa Lakshana is mentioned, then you are differentiating from Abrahma. But in the case of Brahma, what happens is there is no Abrahma also. There is no real Abrahma. Therefore, these points are not discussed elaborately. However, in any Swarupa Lakshana, there is also Vyavartakatva possible. That is mentioned here in the Tika as to Swarupa Lakshane api ukte tannishtam asadharana dharma swarupam. The Swarupa Lakshana, when it talks about something as a Swarupa of an entity, then that Lakshana itself will also reveal something which it isn't. Therefore, Vyavartaka Lakshanam Arthat Siddhyati, implied from that definition will also be differentiation from those which do not have that kind of Swarupa. That is the idea. Dharma Dharmino iti bhava, Dharma Dharmino iti bhashye, dharmascha dharmi cha iti na dvanda samasaha. So generally when you hear Dharma Dharmino ho, it's a dual. So people are used to saying, thinking that it is dharma and dharmi together and itaritara dvandva. It is not itaritara dvandva samasa, kintu dharmanam dharminau iti shashti tatpurusha samasa iti vyachashte. So dharmanam dharminau anatma dharmanam dharmi anatma, atma dharmanam dharmi atma. Then these kind of two dharmis put together in the samasa along with their respective dharmas will go in as dharma dharmino ho in shashti. Shashti tatpurusha, and then the word itself is declined in shashti or saptami as dual. So it is not an itara itara dvanda samasa, but it is a shashti tatpurusha that is mentioned. Dharmas are many. Dharmi is one atma, and then dharmis are many, and there are many anatmas also, but still by the upadi buddhi. So there are many jivas, many anatmas. This anatma is jada prapancha. Therefore, the jiva is not really jada, but the jivatva bhava comes due to this jada prapancha, out of which something is carved out as oneself, one's own body, and then adhyastha on oneself as I am manushya ityadi. But then we are talking about one anatma here, dharmi. In the samasa, dharmi is atma and another dharmi is anatma. But then dharmas, their dharmas are many, and thereby dharmanam dharminau iti shashti tatpurusha samasa iti vyachashte jadya iti. Ratna Prabha, jadya chaitanyadi dharmanam dharminau ahankaratmanau tayoho atyantam bhinnayoho itaretara bhedagrahena anyonyasmin anyonyat tadatmyam anyonya dharmanscha व्यत्यासेन अध्यस्य लोकव्यवहार इति योजना. सो हाउ डज दिस सेंटेंस कनेक्ट, हाउ डू दीज वर्ड्स कनेक्ट इन दी भाष्य हैज बीन शोन एज जाड्य चैतन्य. जाड्य एंड जड एंड अजड, चेतन एंड अचेतन, आत्मा एंड अनात्मा. सो दीज आर दी धर्म, जाड्य चैतन्य आदि धर्माणाम धर्मिणौ. दिस धर्मीज हु हैव जाड्य धर्मास और हैव चैतन्य आदि धर्मास. जाड्यादि जाड्य धर्मास आर मेनी. Chaitanya is not really dharma but talked about as a dharma. Of these dharmis, who are those? Ahankara has jadya dharma, Chaitanya is dharma, swarupa dharma of atma. Therefore, ahankara atmano or anatma atmano. Tayoho atyantam bhinnayoho. Tayoho, tayoho itaretara bheda agraheda. Because of not knowing the bheda between them mutually, mutual bheda. Who are what? Atyanta bhinna. Tamas prakashavad, they are completely opposed to each other, like darkness and light. But then they become one as though anyonyasmin, anyonya tadatmya, tadatmyam. So there is a tadatmyam with each other. There is a sambandha, atma as though becomes anatma, anatma as though becomes atma. There is oneness. Therefore, having mixed up the dharmis, dharmancha vyatyasena adhyasya, vyatyasena which do not belong to atma, those dharmas are superimposed on atma, and those dharmas which do not belong to anatma, like chetana ityadi, they are superimposed on anatma. We think that the body is sentient, it isn't. But the sentience of the atma is adhyasta in anatma deha, and thereby adhyasya lokavyavahara iti yojana. Ataha soyam iti pramayaha na adhyasatvam. In the case of soyam devadatta, if it is soyam devadatta, tatkala taddesha vishishta devadatta is etatkala etaddesha vishishta devadatta. You saw some devadatta 5-10 years back, you saw someone, maybe your friend, you met that person in another place and time. So say 10 years back you met him in Delhi, and now you see him in Bangalore, let's say. So generally what in that desha, something is in that desha cannot be in this desha, something was in that kala cannot be in this kala. But then you look at that person, has changed in 10 years, has changed a lot, but then still you can make out it the same devadatta. So soyam devadatta. There soyam iti pramayaha na adhyasatvam. Is there an adhyasa there? Just like aham manushya. Is it similar case as soyam devadatta? It isn't. In soyam devadatta, although the desha are opposed to each other, Delhi is not Bangalore and Bengaluru now. So Delhi is not Bengaluru, and the dharmas also. Kala is also different. 10 years back, the time was different from the time, current time. So although there is a difference between these, but still the entity is the same. The pinda is the same. That sharira that you look at, the features that you look at have changed. In sharira also features have changed. He has put on a lot of weight. So if you look at the person, but still there is a pratyabhijna soyam devadatta. In that jnana, is there an adhyasa? So it is not that kind of situation. There is no adhyasa there. Why? Because in that case, iti pramayaha, in that jnana, pramayaha na adhyasatvam soyam devadatta ityatra. Tadidam arthayoho kalabhedena deshabhedena api kalpita bheda api. There is a kalpita bheda. Desha is different. Oh, Delhi, the same person cannot be in Delhi and Bengaluru at the same time though. Times are different. Therefore, can be. There is a kalpita bheda. Oh, that person was different. Oh, so someone, you know, another friend of yours may say, no, he is different. So therefore, kalpita bheda is possible. Oh, it is a different person. It is not Devadatta. But still, you know that it is Devadatta. No, I am sure it is Devadatta. Let's go and talk to him. So, kalpita bheda api atyanta bheda bhava. There is no atyanta bheda. The bheda is kalpita. Desha kala bhedena kalpita bheda in Devadatta. But there is no bheda at all. So someone may say, you know, how can he be here? He's in Delhi. He never told us that he's going to come to Bengaluru. He would have said. So with all these ideas, you can say, oh no, it can't be that person. So kalpita bheda is there. However, atyanta bheda is not there. Impossibility isn't there. But in tamah prakasha becoming one, there is an impossibility. Darkness and light cannot be the same. You cannot confuse darkness with light. Similarly, in this case, atyanta viviktayoho. Bhagavan Bhashyakara says that it is not like soyam devadatta. It has to be an adhyasa. Atyanta bheda bhavat in soyam devadatta case iti vaktum atyanta iti uktam. Atyanta has been shown here to differentiate from such kind of places where you have oneness between the two by pratyabhijna, but here that is not possible. Nacha dharmitadatmi adhyase dharmadhyasa siddhehe dharmanscha iti vyartham iti vachyam. Then dharmi adhyasa has been mentioned, that is sufficient. Why do you talk about dharmadhyasa? Why? Because dharmi adhyasa means dharmadhyasa. This is the objection. So dharmadhyasa discussion is vyartha. Nacha vachyam, says the Siddhanti. Why? Andhatvadinam indriya dharmanam dharmyadhyasa sputatve api andhoham iti sputo adhyasa iti jnapanarthatvat. Gives an example case. There is dharmyadhyasa, there is dharmadhyasa. These two are different adhyasas. There are some cases, it is not always that they go together. Or at least clearly there is no understanding as to both go together. And they need not go together also. At least in one case it is not together. So other case also can be misunderstood as they may not go together. Therefore clearly it has to be mentioned that there is an adhyasa at the dharma level also, not only at the dharmi level. Although earlier it was mentioned that dharma adhyasa is impossible without dharmi adhyasa. Therefore, dharmi adhyasa should be accepted. Here it is clearly mentioned as dharma adhyasa also takes place. Whereas there can be a confusion as dharma adhyasa is there, dharmi adhyasa is not there. Some cases it is there. This example case is andhatva is a indriya dharma. It is not there in the person. One cannot say, you know, I am blind. But one ends up saying, I am blind. Why? Because blindness is the property resting in the Chakshurindriya. But does one say that I am the eye? Being Chakshurindriya Dharma, Andhatva will be in the Chakshu. So Andhatva is the Dharma, whereas Dharmi is Chakshu. I am a human being, let's say. I consider myself as separate from it. I am some entity who does not consider oneself as eyes. Nobody says that I am the eyes. But the dharma of the eyes one considers as oneself. How so? Andhoham. Andhatva is a dharma of the Chakshurindriya. Although I don't have dharmi adhyasa, I don't ever make a statement that I am the eyes. But still, the property of the eyes I consider as mine. I say I am blind. Therefore, without dharmi adhyasa, also dharma adhyasa is possible. That being so, one may think that dharmi adhyasa is possible, dharma adhyasa may not be possible. Therefore, dharma adhyasa is specifically mentioned. Thereby, Bhagavan Bhashyakara specifically talked about dharma adhyasa also, and you should not bring about this objection as it is futile. Nacha dharmi tadatmi adhyase dharmadhyasa siddhe dharmansha iti vyartham iti vachyam. By dharmi adhyasa is also established. You should not say that because why? Andhatvadinam indriya dharmanam. Andhatva ityadi are indriya dharma, chakshur indriya dharmas. Dharmi adhyasa asputatvi api. Dharmi adhyasa is not clear there, but it should be accepted. Otherwise, dharma adhyasa is not possible. Although I do not say I am the eyes, still there is a confusion there because dharmas have been confused with aham iti sputa adhyasa iti jnapanarthatvam. So aham andha, that vyavahara is there and thereby aham chakshu kind of a vyavahara not being there also shows that there is some adhyasa there at dharmi level also, after which this dharma adhyasa has been possible and the statement aham anda has been made. That is the bhash, the Ratna Prabha Tika we look at the next part. After few days, as I mentioned, you know, the Saraswati Avahana today evening. After that, you know, Saraswati rests. So we'll let Mother Saraswati rest and we'll not study or have classes, have the class on Dashara, on Vijayadashmi. Yamiha karunikam sharanam gatvapyari sahodarapamahatpadam. Tamaham ashu harim paramashre janaka jankam anansa sukha krutim. Sorry, what was the comment there? Did someone say something?
No, I wanted to confirm 15th.
Let me just check. 12th and 14th, no class. 14th is anyway Thursday. 12:30 no classes. 14th, 15th, Friday. Okay, namaste.
Namaste.